Fiddle egg night, folks. Spring has sprung, the fervours are cracking on. Here in Live for the Lounge, it's in the Howe of Cremar, number 55, Live for the Lounge. If I had the opportunity, I would have gone back and started again, because that was a bit of a rumble, but nice to see you, folks. Right, number 55, and much the same sort of stuff as normal. Music, song, banter, say your hellos, we'll be here, we'll try and pass them on. We do try to cover Arthur, and if somebody's got questions or says hello or guesses for various things, we definitely try to get it in, but do miss stuff now and again. So here's Shona.
Hello, I nearly fell into shot there.
Tripped into the shot.
Tripped over all the cables.
All right, Ferners are all gone flat out just now. Well, it's not so much pluing just now, that's kind of been down around about here, but they've got the horrors out, kind of leveling things out. So,
it's fine to see, isn't it?
Busy time of the year for the Ferners. World hour, springtime busy, autumn with the Hurst busy. So, it's a busy time of the year if you've got crops in. So, there you go. Now, any statements you want to make, Shona?
I didn't think so. I don't think I've got anything interesting to say.
Let's just go on something interesting.
What's in the box? 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 What's in the box?
What's in the box?
What's in the box?
What's in the box?
I don't think I can put in the box in it. You have to keep the lid in the box.
Hold on.
Oh, that was close.
Over vigorous shocking. I must have had ketchup at tea time.
Oh, somebody's at the door.
Do you want to go and see?
I better go and
see
who's at the
door. I'll hold the fort just now. Okay. Who the hell could be at this time of night? Anyway. It's not part of the show. It's not a special guest. It's not Santa Claus. So anyway, what do you think? Now, there's very little to go on, but who knows? Something's in the box. I took a photo in my box last weekend, I think it was, I can't remember which night, and posted it, and I put what's in the box, and all these folk were guessing. There was nothing in the box at the time, but I had to go and find something, so I put something in. So there you go. But I'm just curious, what's at the door? It's humans for the outside world. We'll find out about that shortly. But so I'm going to start. Follows at the door.
I can't believe in 55 weeks we've never had anybody ring a phone or ring a doorbell.
Well, been locked down, so.
No, but you would
shouldn't
think
have been out anywhere.
Folk might be ringing a phone.
So far, was it the door?
It was a fixed site. It was a young loon out on his bike, and he'd said, "There's three sheep in the road," and I says, "Well, it's near your sheep, so I'm sorry, I can't help you." I says, "I'm sure somebody will see them and give Andrew a
Well, Andrew's
phone.
Probably out in a park somewhere, so he wouldn't hear. But Andrew, if you're watching, three of your sheep are on the road. They were in the back of the silage pit there over the last few days, but they've gotten louse.
Well,
I'm surprised.
The
fence is kind of. So, anyway, mystery solved.
It was after nice of to stop and say there's three sheep in the road, but this is, I'm sorry, then
you got a good loonies. Very socially minded up. So, I'm delighted to hear that. But anyway, excitement's over. I'm going to crack on. Possibly be trying to pick this off. I'm going to start with this tonight. Now, earlier in the week, I said, right, I'm going to have a go at playing King Robert the Bruce. Now, it occurred to me last week, actually, last Friday, that I could play it. Because last Friday, which was my granny's birthday, 25th of March, was actually the anniversary of the coronation of King Robert the Bruce. And it would have been an ideal tune to play last Friday, but I kind of had my programme made up, and I was going to jiggle it about. And then I had a go at the tune. I thought, actually, I need a 2 or 3 days to have practice of that. Actually, probably need a 2 or 3 weeks to practice it. But I thought, being somebody that likes a challenge, I would have a go the night. I'm going to start with it. I'm going to get it out of the road. King Robert the Bruce by James Scott Skinner. It's, well, of course, it's not notorious if you can play it, but it's notoriously difficult to play it. Now, I've never played this in concert, and I had to learn it for a championship competition at Bankery Festival many years ago. And I'll be honest, I didn't really care for it a great deal, and I never played it again after the competition. But I'm going to play it tonight, see how we get on. The style's very much Skinner. His tune, Sir William Wallace, I think is a great tribute to William Wallace. To me, this doesn't really capture, to my mind, King Robert the Bruce. It's a wee bit pompous. bit let the camp for you think, but it is a real tester for fiddlers, and probably that's why I hear it very often. But it's sometimes played at championships when folk are wanting to impress a judge and show what they can do. So I'm reckoning there's about 50-50 chance here of me getting this wrong. So let's see how we get to him.
It's fine.
Thank you. fault. I'm going to play slow ears for the rest of the night now.
You pick off with that?
Yeah, well, it gets out the road. So.
Oh my goodness gracious, mate. There's a lot of folks saying on your cell, basically.
Oh, well, that's fine.
I've got quite a lot of hellos to do. I'm seeing some.
You can spit for a minute or I'll catch my breath.
Can you sweat and look at you?
Taste some of this beer, my mystery beer, Bugs. Like, take a look. It's an intense beverage.
Intense beverage.
Mm. So we'll come to that in a second, but Shona's got a few
greetings
and hellos.
Katinka Baxton over in the Netherlands is watching, as is Harry Lash in the Netherlands. Gordon Caller in Udney, in Bonnie Woodney, Shirley and John Fox in Skeen. The Brandys and Lawrence Kirk are joining us. Bonnie in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Sally Dave Butler is watching. Mike and Karen Dune in Glasgow. Ulla in Stockholm. Lorelei Bach in Pennsylvania. Uncle Tommy and Auntie Sonia are in Huntley. And I hope you've got a wee drammy the night. Friday night. He says he's stuffed. He's had three courses the night. Anne and Paul, our Helen Lumphanan, they are on the gin cocktails because Anne is off for a couple of days and they had spaghetti and meatballs for the tea.
Oh, fine.
Sounds really good. We bought meatballs today.
Aye, venison meatballs. That's like the game money comes to Tarland in a bind. But he said, mystery. He says, he thinks somebody's on one holiday because he was at West Hull for an hour and they had one customer. He was in Bunkery for an hour, he got no customers, and I think he was pleased to see me for coming about the day. So
we really like his burgers. He does pheasant and black pudding burgers, which are ace.
And other things.
And amongst other things.
Like wild boar and venison and stuff like that. It's fine.
Shona Robertson and the clan Doon in the Aberdeen Arms. Grace and Matt, my mum and dad out in Huntley. John Peterson up in Shetland is joining us. Sue Taylor in Orkney. Sandy Thompson in Dingwall, Ian and Anne, your mum and dad up behind the hill, Alison McDonald from the San Francisco Bay area, Tracy and Hugh Adelsey are watching, Jane Roberts in Philadelphia, Nicola Mitchell's watching, as is Isabel Ling and our guy, Alexander Thompson up in Peterhead, Rona and Charlie in the village, Joe and Pat Aitken in Kirriemuir, and Jamie Bowers, and Annie McCluskey is watching. She's in a wee room trying to do some studying. But she said that a few wee lassies have snuck through to do some dancing to Paul. So hello, Kenna and Callie and Lexi, if you're watching. And I expect some great dancing later on.
So, McCaskill's.
McCluskey's.
McCluskey's, Harry, okay.
Annie McCluskey and Billy. Right, Billy will be there somewhere.
I've got a tune about a McCaskill later, but wrong name. So
no, McCluskey.
McCluskey name. I'm later writing for them.
Okay.
So, aye, so the beer. Now, it made Shona flinch.
Oh God.
It's I would say it's quite heavily flavoured with hops. It's definitely Scottish and you can see it's kinda cloudy. It's like it's a colour of water from the fluid through a pipe and it's fizzy. And I've seen it coming through that colour as well. You wouldn't necessarily drink it, put it through the kettle first, but anyway. But you can see it is fizzing. But some folk would like that. It's all right. There's nothing wrong with it, but it's definitely quite a strong flavour. So let us ken what you think that might be a fine Scottish ale. So there we go. Aye.
Do you like it?
It's all right. I mean, it's like quite a lot of them. You kind of got quite a strong flavour, and some folk like that. I can don't like it necessarily all the time, but. If somebody put it under my nose, I would drink it. Of course, I So, Shona mentioned Tommy and Sonia. Her uncle Tommy and Sonia got married 5 years ago the day. So, this set's really going to be dedicated to you.
Can we come and sing happy anniversary to you?
Aye, and is there a tune for that?
No. It's just the same tune as happy birthday, I'm hoping.
Okay.
I've never thought this through.
Aye, well,
Tommy and Sonia.
We'll find out.
Happy anniversary to you. Happy anniversary to you. Happy anniversary, Tommy and Sonia. Happy anniversary to you. And many more. Would you like to know an interesting fact? This is a dress that I wore to their wedding.
Look at that.
I put it on tonight just because it's the exact dress that I wore to their wedding. Although, do you remember I had my hair up in a really fancy thing? And then the next morning, you took that photo of me, and I had my eyeliner was down here, and my hair was like a rat's nest, wasn't it?
But drag through the hedge, but
it was a brilliant wedding, but the day after was Miss Brilliant, I must say.
I have to say I was alright. It was a good wedding.
It was a brilliant wedding.
They're both great bowlers, and quite a lot of the wedding was in the bowling club.
Yep.
Was it?
Yep, and then up to Club X.
Aye. So, right, as I was saying, this is going to be for you, Tommy and Sonia. No, it's easy to see why happy anniversary to you. Didn't catch on quite so well as happy birthday.
Okay.
It fits a bit better. But aye, so last weekend, I took Shona up to the Blue Cairn with the boys. We went up. I've been up with the boys. I was up with the school when I was a kid, but I took the boys up last year. Was up and I wrote a tune called the Blue Cairn, and took Shona and the boys up on Sunday, was it? And Shona had never been up, so I decided I was going to play this, but because it's Tommy and Sonia's anniversary, I'm going to play a tune that was written for them, and it's just called Purple Fuchsia, and as yet I'm still not sure why Purple Fuchsia, but there'll be a romantic reason for it, so if you want to maybe fire on the questions to Tommy, he'll maybe tell you. Maybe maybe winner, so we'll see. And then I'm going to finish with a reel after that, one of my own again. It's just called The Lecht. And anybody from this part of the world would ken The Lecht. It's famous mountain pass, and it's got some of the local ski slopes up there, which they might actually have some snow over the next few days because the forecast isn't very good. So, three of my own tunes there.
Thank you.
Shona says thank you very much, everybody. Happiest day of our lives.
Good stuff. It was a good day. Okay. I missed the start of it, actually. I was playing.
We were playing somewhere.
Kind of my
but I played my fiddle.
Yep.
As background music. And
the boys were half spivved up.
They were.
Right.
I've got a few more hellos. Donald and Sandra Gibson in Torthorwald, which I am definitely visiting Torthorwald once we can get out of lockdown. Kate and Jim Taylor, our in Garlogie. Kirsten Lakin in Washington State is joining us. Susan Kirkwood, Dune and Dunfermline. Liz and Roger Court in Lincolnshire. Laura Murray is watching. Leah Rosswall up in Bucky. David and Fiona Gardner. Margot and Edward Stewart in Dunn & Dool. Aileen Barber's watching. Chris Caldwell and Sandy White and Ian and Norma Russell.
Good stuff.
And I've got some guesses.
Okay, so I think we're going first.
So, box. I don't mind, yeah. What's in the box? 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 What's in the box?
It's a ghost of Terry Wogan.
Nah, Paul Gray thinks it might be the doorbell.
Yep.
Bill Brandy thinks a pair of falsers, a pair of false teeth. Katinka Baxton thinks nail polish. Ulla thinks lipstick and Gordon Collar thinks a golf ball.
Okay.
I must say, that wasn't me sneezing. I took a drink of Iron Brew and it went down the wrong way and I had to cough. Everybody was saying bless you. Like that. So, what is the brew? What is the brew? What is the brew?
A different tune,
what
I think,
is the brew? Katinka thinks Heineken.
Well, it's near that, because that's near Scottish.
Bill Brandy thinks 6 degrees north brew.
Yep.
Sandy Thompson thinks Fruch. I think that's how you say it, Fruch. Heather Ale.
Fruch.
Fruch. Fruch.
Yep.
Alison MacDonald thinks Thirst Dog, and John Folks thinks Windrush.
Windrush. Okay.
There you go.
There you go. Right. I'm going to play one more tune just now, and then Sean will be up to gear.
Yeah.
A few songs. I played this last year, but it came into my head again this week, and I just fancied playing it again. Once is not enough to hear such a good tune. It's an old slow air card, Lord Balgoni's favourite, which was the tune that Robert Tannehill set Gloomy Winter's Noo a' Wa' to. Yes,
I sung it last week.
Did you?
I think I sung it last week. That's maybe why you were thinking of it. Or the week before.
I think it was at least a couple of weeks ago. Anyway.
Doesn't matter, because a good tune's near the water playing twice.
Could play it ourselves.
Exactly.
Could play it every week if we wanted, but need to do that, try and rearrange things. But it's been a wee while since I played it, but it's a lovely tune, and folk who like films like the classic movie directed by Jane Campion, The Piano, with Harvey Keitel and Holly Hunter, and what else was Sam Neill is in it as well. So a good cast, great film, actually a really good soundtrack. However, Michael Nyman, who composed the soundtrack, said that he was inspired by Scottish music when he composed the score. But he pretty much just lifted all tunes and claimed he's written them. It's pretty cheeky. In fact, it's worse than cheeky. But I'm not going to say any more. But anyway, this is the main theme for the piano in its original form, Lord Balgoni's favourite. And for it says, I say the music is a very old Highland tune, as for it says. But it's a beautiful melody, and I'm just going to say it actually sounded great in the film. So there you go. But if you hear it in the soundtrack, you will recognise it right away. So, Lord Balgoni's favourite.
Thank you.
beautiful tune.
Yeah, so that is the tune for Tannehill's, Robert Tannehill's Gloomy Winter's New
War. Gloomy Winter's New Year War as well.
Yeah, I've got a couple of birthdays if you'd like to
oh,
do
that. Birthdays. What tune are we going to play for that?
Happy birthday. We'll play the happy anniversary tune to it, I think.
There must be a tune for the anniversary song.
I don't know. I've never heard an anniversary song, so... Congratulations.
Something in the back of my head somewhere, but anyway, doesn't matter.
So, I want to say happy birthday to Leah Oswald's sister Freya, whose birthday is tomorrow. And also, on the 31st of March, it was Lorelei's youngest son, George. It was his birthday. So we're going to sing happy birthday to George and to Freya.
Okay?
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, George and Freya. Happy birthday to you. George, I hope you had a wonderful day. And Freya, I hope you have a wonderful day.
Okay, well, I jump out the line.
Yeah, I've got a few guesses.
All right, we'll sit a lot for that.
Yeah, so one guess for the What's the Brew?
Oh, if it's a brew.
Jamie Bowers thinks Joker or Alba.
Well, I shouldn't have shot that though, should I?
No. What's on the brew? What's in the brew? Don't get it mixed up. In the box, there was a flurry of guesses in. So, Nicola Mitchell thinks a cream egg. Joe Aitken thinks a chocolate Easter egg. Liz Court thinks a wee wooden crucifix. Lorelei Bach thinks a Cadbury's egg. Sandy Thompson thinks a wee Easter bunny, not a real one. Rona thinks a hard-boiled egg. Katinka Baxton thinks a chocolate bunny. John Folks thinks a mini Easter egg. Harry Lash thinks a good old chunk of chocolate. Jamie Bowers thinks a bracelet. And Leah thinks a Malteser bunny. So a lot of chocolate guesses there.
Well, who
we
knows?
Don't
wait. You'll have to wait till the end to find out.
Have to wait.
Right, I'll leave Shona till it. I'll get a look at the road. You go, Shona.
Okay,
we flash the hairy spot out.
Right, okay. So, oops, I'm going to do a couple of songs just now. My throat hasn't been great. I think I mentioned last week that my throat wasn't quite right. And I only did 3 songs last week. It's actually, today is the best day that it's been since last Friday. It's kind of one of those throats that kind of feels really dry and scratchy and sore to swallow. In fact, Roddy was off school last Friday. Hector was off school on Thursday with the same, although he's not going to school, but we still have to email in to say that he's not attending home learning. But he basically just lay in his bed and did his work as usual. He did it a wee bit later on. So it's kind of going round. Today is the best day. Do you want to come and say hi?
Yeah.
Okay. Roddy's here.
Hi.
Hello. Have you got anything exciting to tell us this week?
Not really.
Not really. You're on holiday now?
Yeah.
Yeah? Yeah. You went on holiday yesterday, so today was your first day of official holidays. Mm. What are you thinking about doing in the holidays?
No idea.
No idea. Making some food?
Yeah, definitely.
What would you like? Oh, you better tell them what we bought at the shop yesterday. Yeah.
A huge salmon.
A huge salmon. A whole salmon. How big was it, Roddy?
It's like...
How, you hold your hands out. And he's not exaggerating that it is this big. It's a massive big salmon. So you're really looking forward to doing that. Well, yeah. How do you think we should cook it?
I think we should just like cut it into pieces, then do it on the barbecue.
Okay. That sounds pretty good. Any sauce or anything with it? Or...
Like a spicy kind of sauce.
A spicy sauce? Like a marinade?
Yeah.
Okay, that sounds
and
pretty good.
Like, mix it through rice.
Well, that does sound really good, Rodrick.
Just kind of, nice.
Yeah, I think that sounds great. I think we need to get your MasterChef application off. Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Sure.
Junior MasterChef? Yeah, you better get practicing. You're going to make tea tomorrow night then?
Sure.
Okay, cool. Right,
yeah, I was also thinking of making a cake.
Oh, were you? What kind of cake were you going to make?
Any cake.
Any cake? Any cake's good.
Yeah.
Yeah, quite right. Okay. Thank you very much, Roderick. That's Roddy's recipe for this week. So, what was I saying? I can't remember what I was saying. Doesn't really matter. Oh, yeah, I've had a sore throat. That's about it. Nothing very exciting. So, if I do have a few scraeches and screeches the night, you'll ken why. It's because of my throat. So, yeah, you seem to have missed it all, don't you?
Yeah.
Yeah. I've not. Roddy's not and Hector's not. So it's coming, Paul. It's coming yet for all that.
It'll be fine.
Okay, so I'm going to sing... I don't think I've done this one before. It's a song called The Irish Boy. I think I can't remember when I first heard it, actually. And it's, I suppose it's a version of Will Ya Gang or Wally Wally doing the bank or up the bay, I can't remember which one it is. So it's the Irish boy, and I'll give Bash. There's a lot of verses in here that you'll find in other songs. Roddy's whistling his head off, can you hear that?
Mm-hmm.
So this is the Irish boy. There sits a bird on yonder tree. Some say he's blind and cannot see. Oh, how I wish that bird was me, since my true love has left me. And oh, what a foolish young girl was I, to fall in love with an Irish boy. An Irish boy he may well be, but he spoke buried Scots when he courted me. I leaned my back against an oak, thinking it was a trusty tree. But first it bent and then it broke, just like my true love did to me. And oh, what a foolish young girl was I, to fall in love with an Irish boy. An Irish boy he may well be, but he spoke buried Scots when he courted me. I wish, oh I wish in vain, I wish I were a maid again. But a maid again I ne'er shall be, till an apple grows on an orange tree. And oh, what a foolish young girl was I, to fall in love with an Irish boy. An Irish boy he may well be, but he spoke buried Scots when he courted me. I wish my babe was born and sitting on his daddy's knee. And I myself were dead and gone, and the green, green grass growing o'er me. And oh, what a foolish young girl was I, to fall in love with an Irish boy. An Irish boy he may well be, but he spoke buried Scots when he courted me.
Gosh, I need a right proper host after that. The Irish boy.
Lovely.
And I sung that for quite a while, actually. Mum's saying she minds Anne Reid singing it at Killarley. And I think you might be right, actually. I'm sure I have heard Anne Reid singing that. Phyllis Martin, I think, sings it as well. So, as a lot of you all know, today is Good Friday. Happy Easter, everybody. And we usually have Frank Ribbons with us, but Frank is actually at the Easter service tonight, so he's going to watch back. But Frank got in touch during the week and said, would I sing something Eastery? So I had a wee look, and I came across this song in a very old copy of Songs of God's People. I think my granny gave it to me quite a while ago. And it was written by a minister called Ian Cowie, who, as well as being a minister, was a member of the Iona community. And it's set to a traditional Scottish song
called Pullen Bracken, or sometimes known as Cutting Ferns, Cutting Bracken, Hammy Ski, Buanaranich. There's quite a lot of different tunes for it. You're playing on this, oh, Paul. Okay. We have not had a rehearsal of this, so I have no idea how this is going to go.
Certainly thought, wait a minute.
Could I play basically, this? I think about 5 minutes before we started, I said, Paul, could you do this? And we'll, give this a bash. Can I just tune with you? Because I'm doing fiddle for this as well.
I'm going to sit at the back and watch faces.
Yeah, I'm not. Can I just get an A from you, please? So I'll just make sure I'm in tune. Is that okay?
That's fine. Yeah.
Oh, that'll be. Oh, I just see Dorian Wood is watching. I don't know what Melvin's up to tonight.
He could be in the kirk as
well. In the kirk as well. So, yeah, this is a song called Lifted High on Your Cross. And to the tune of Pullen Bracken or Cutting Ferns or whatever you want. And I actually noticed that it's quite similar to Drummond Castle. Is that a traditional tune or did somebody write it? Well, somebody obviously wrote it. But
I've heard it said that Neil Gow wrote it, but one of the collections I've got, I don't think I've seen his name attached to it, but I've heard it said, but I think it's such a good Scottish reel, I think. If Neil Gow had written it, it would have been well documented.
Yeah, yeah. It definitely does.
It's a great tune, though.
Dorian's saying, hi, Shona and Paul. Late to the party tonight. Been watching The Sound of Music. We watched it last weekend because Roddy said he'd never seen it.
Yeah.
I want to give a blast of a Sound of Music song now. The only one off the top of my head. Hi, oh, little old lick, old turk, lady, old lady, old lady, woo hoo. That's the best yodeling I've ever heard.
No fly, sure. I wish I could yodel.
That's been an ambition of mine. For the past about 4 years, that's been my New Year's resolution to learn to yodel.
That's the Austrian guy.
Franzl. I can't mind his name.
Something France, wasn't it?
Yeah, he's an amazing yodeler. Aye. I love a yodel.
He wears fancy hats with lederhosen on.
Yeah. I was saying to you, The Sound of Music, I want a sequel. I want a sequel to The Sound of Music, but all about the Baroness, because I think her story needs to be told.
She's bitter.
Yeah, I mean, imagine catching old Georg there, and then a nun with a bowl cut and a guitar comes in. See you later. So, anyway.
She could run up on a pair of multicoloured trousers you can't mention.
Ooh, a pair of curtains. That was, when I was little, all I wanted was a dress made out of a pair of curtains. So, right, anyway, I'm going to sing this song. This is called Lifted High on Your Cross, because today is Good Friday, written by Ian Cowie to the Scottish tune Pullen Bracken. Lift and high on your cross, drawing all folk, lifted high on your cross, drawing all folk to you. Down you come to live among us, part of your creation, knowing poverty and sorrow, sharing each temptation. Lifted high on your cross, drawing all folk, lifted high on your cross, drawing all folk to you. On the gallows there they nailed you, God despised, rejected. Deep within the earth they hide you till you're resurrected. Lifted high on your cross, drawing all folk, drawing all folk. Lifted high on your cross, drawing all folk to you. Light and love pour down upon us, healing, recreating. You to live your life within us, all life consecrating. Lifted high on your cross, drawing all folk, drawing all folk. Lifted high on your cross, drawing all folk to you. Lifted high on your cross, drawing all folk, drawing all folk. Lifted high on your cross.
the shop where I was sitting.
Okay, cool. Oh yeah, my great uncle Aki was a brilliant yodeler. Oh man, I really wish I could yodel. I should learn, shouldn't I? Maybe for the 2 year anniversary of Live from the Lounge, I'll learn to yodel. Right, Paul, I'll let you back on.
Oh, sorry.
Sorry,
just leave it all sorted.
Right, so we don't have any guesses.
Oh.
Actually, I had some written down there.
I'm just having a look back through.
Right. I'm going to play a march Strathspian reel. This is MacLean of Pennycross. Then I'm going to play Davy Taylor and Peter Gray after it, so that's a march Strathspian reel. What was you going to say, Shona?
I was just going to read your guesses.
Yep.
Uncle Tommy thinks that in the box is a large piece of Toblerone with false teeth.
Mm-hmm.
Harry Lash thinks it's Wooha beer. Sandy Thompson thinks Brewdog Hazy Jane. Mm-hmm. Liz Court, or was it Roger Court? I think it was maybe Roger that thought it was a miniature picture of Last Supper. And Ian Russell thinks the beer's old Reeky.
A few years ago, we actually were in Northumberland for a week, and we went to see a lot of things. Alnwick Castle, Hadrian's Wall, went to see relatives. And one day we decided, let's go on Friday to Lindisfarne, which I'd never been, which was a big mistake because it was Good Friday.
Yeah, I know.
And it was heaving. I would imagine it's probably one of the busiest days of the year there. And it was the first time I realised that Easter is celebrated much more in England than it is in Scotland, because, I mean, folks celebrate it, certainly, but maybe it's because we were near Lindisfarne that it was obvious, but I think it's much more thing doing in England than it is up here. I think the highlight Easter for me was the Easter eggs. We used to roll eggs every year, actually.
Yeah.
So, anyway.
I just like hot cross buns.
Yeah, I'm quite partial myself. Right, the march is a Spain reel anyway. Thank you.
David Taylor was my great-great-great-great-grandfather.
Maybe it was
not
him.
Not that David Taylor.
You never can.
Well, it could have been.
Could have been.
I don't think he was running about the same time as Skinner.
Believe it or not.
Could he?
Well, Skinner was born in 1843.
Yeah, I suppose he would. Maybe it is that David
maybe
Taylor.
Listen, he spent time doing near Dundee, playing Dundee plenty, so maybe he would.
Well, maybe it is.
Maybe it is.
Maybe that's why I like it so
maybe
much.
The spiritual connection.
So in the box, Alison MacDonald thinks it's a cross, and Paul Gray thinks a small Easter chick. And for the brew tonight, Gordon Calder thinks Maryland's Scottish Pale Ale, mm-hmm. and Nicola Mitchell thinks Innes and Gunn. I want to say hello to Elaine Mitchell, who has just finished her work, and she noticed that George got on himself tonight, so...
Excellent. Well done, George.
I didn't see your name coming up, George, otherwise I would have said hello to you earlier, but hello... Fine to see you. And Joe Aitken tried yodeling but with no success. So
yeah.
I don't care anybody that yodels.
I care how you feel.
I don't care anybody that I kind of think off the top of my head, anybody that I ken that can yodel.
Well, I would like to have kent Slim Whitman because he can yodel a bit.
Oh, yeah.
He'd agree, boys. I love Slim Whitman.
I kind of think, anybody that we ken that can yodel.
There was a boy who used to come to the session that yodeled it. But that was the only one. He'd one tune. She taught me to yodel a yodel.
What was that?
You've heard enough.
Oh, that's funny.
That's your Russian and my yodel.
Oh, I'm noticing that. It's Alan and Rona Taylor in the Ufford. Sorry we're late. That's all right. I'll just
it's
use
right.
a
you missed
black mark. Yeah, you've come in at the right time, Alan, because you've missed Paul trying to yodel. Oh,
my eyebrows were higher than my singing.
That's quite funny. Yeah. Okay, you get that practice for next week. If you can play Robert the Bruce, you can yodel.
No. No. That doesn't work like that, I'm afraid. No, I think I'd rather play King Robert the Bruce. Anyway, that's quite a good cue, Shona, because I played King Robert the Bruce first half. I'm going to play Sir William Wallace in the second half. What's that now, Shona?
Mum is asking, she's got a question. When you play, you seem to watch the bow and not your fingers. Am I right? And why? I would have thought the fingers would have been more difficult.
I don't really. It's just habit, Grace. I don't really need to look on it. In fact, I could sit here with my mind shut and play.
It's just some way to look.
Yeah, I could. I mean, I could shut mine, for instance. That's how you get to that. But I don't need really to have my mind open because it's mainly due to muscle memory. But it's a lot to do with where your face is. I find that I'm looking down the fiddle and I'm not really, it sounds a bit arty, but I'm not really focused on my fingers or the bow as far as my eyes appear to be. But I'm not really looking at anything, to be quite honest. I'm kind of concentrating without really seeing very much. I'm kind of focused. Mm. Near internally then, but of course my inner open. It's pretty rude to play your audience with your eyes shut, really, whether you're singing or playing an instrument, and unless you're totally getting into it. But I've never really been asked that very often, ever. Possibly ever. I have no, and that's not through folks. If what you're looking at, nearly anything is my answer. That was a long-winded answer to say that, but I could see why you would say that because actually I'm looking down the neck of the fiddle, so I'm actually. I'm looking at the bow, but actually I can see my fingers at the same time. And if I'm like that, so the looking down the fiddle, I'm not actually having to look to reference for it, a bit my fingers or my bow.
See,
actually.
That's why I don't wear a sparkly nail varnish because it makes my eyes go funny when I'm playing.
Yeah.
I get really distracted by my sparkly nails.
It's like driving in the snow.
Yeah. Or
right.
There's a bit of a Slim Whitman City Divine thing going on here.
Are you kidding? Somebody they've got that two names in the same sentence.
John Fuchs, Sydney Divine yodeled.
Yeah, but they're like Slim. I'm going to stand up in here and I'm going to say no.
Or Daria says she doesn't look at the road either when she's driving.
On that note, let's go into one. Well, we had the great Scottish King Robert the Bruce. We're going to hear the great patriotic hero, you would call him, Sir William Wallace, which is a pastoral air. Now, I've been asked if it's a pastoral air, if it's different between that and a slow air, and I actually couldn't tell you. I'll be quite honest. It feels like a kind of Victorian terminology thing, but Skinner used to call things pastoral airs, but I'm not sure it was widely used. But that's just my ignorance. I've no idea if it makes any difference, so there you go. Anyway, you look like you're laughing, Shona.
Joe Aitken says, trust your mother-in-law to ask upward questions.
Well, listen, it's a very searching, very good question, I feel. But hopefully I've addressed your concerns there. So. Skinner tunes months ago, it seems like.
Anne Wyatt would like to know if a pastoral air tastes of fruit pastels.
Yes.
Yes. Specifically, the purple one.
Raspberry flavoured.
I've got a few guesses. I think I've done this one. Oh, Bill Brandy thinks the brew might be something from Caledonia Brewery.
Okay.
And Ian Russell thinks in the box it might be a wee woggle.
A woggle?
A woggle. Is it not a woggle that the scouts wear?
Is it a woggle or a toggle? No, it's a woggle. You're right.
It is a woggle.
It's a woggle. I was in the Cubs as well, so I think it was a woggle.
It?
It's been a while, of course. So
well, I'm presuming that's what he's meaning.
Used to keep you had a scarf on your neck and it used to kind of keep it too.
Right. And Liz Court thinks it could be a toy lamb.
A toy lamb? Oh, that's kind of seasonal as well.
Yeah, right. Eastery guesses. Okay.
Right.
Is that you? Are you done?
No.
Oh, sorry.
It's alright.
Here was the other way to start singing. Sorry,
yeah,
sorry.
Oh, it's alright. I'm just going to rattle through a few reels that came into my head this week as well. Kind of played the first two since about 1996, actually. It was a band I used to play with, and it was one of their sets that used to start dances with a Cayley band. And this is an Irish reel called The Silver Spire, and that's going to go into Lexi McCaskill. I thought that's for the McCluskey. I was getting mixed up with McCluskey's McCaskill's, but Lexi McCaskill, and then finish with Jenny Dung the Weaver.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
The glamorous one arrives.
I've got a guess for what's in the box. Bill Brandy thinks it might be a yo-yo, and Paul Gray says if it's name moving, is it just a yo? And that put me in mind, actually, I might sing it next week. I hadn't heard it for donkeys. Do you kind of song, am I what I say? The only song I can about a yo-yo.
What's up?
The Reed Yo-Yo. Matt McGinn song. We Anne had a yo-yo to school. She did go, though she should nae teen it at ta. Do you mind it? It fell fae ar han, and it rolled on the ground, and it went through a hole in the wall. Did you find a reed yo-yo, reed yo-yo, reed yo-yo? Did you find a reed yo-yo, wee-a-wee-a, the string? Might do that next week. We used to sing that when I was little. Yeah, Paul has played tonight. Did you play first King Robert the Bruce?
Mm-hmm.
And then you did William Wallace. So I thought I would just do some in along the
heroic lines.
And I'm going to do a song that Robert Burns wrote in 1793. The official title is Robert Bruce's March to Bannockburn. But Abdi kens it is Scotswahy. So I'm going to give it a bash. Again, this is a song that I've never ever sung. And I ken why. The tune is Hey Tutti Tatti. Is that right? Hey Tutti Tatti.
Supposedly it's contemporary with the battle. It's, the reason they use it is because it was, legend has it, that it was sung on the white of the battlefield.
It was also meant to have been played, the tune Hey Tutti Tatti, at the Battle of how do you say it? Orleans.
Orleans.
Not New Orleans, but the old one. Orleans.
Sound French.
Jonah
Arc.
Jonah Arc, yeah. Oh. It was meant to be played there as well.
I believe that, because it was Scots.
My mum says, I love the way you two go off on tangents. This is just what happens in our house all the time. Honestly.
It's the tune for Land of the Leal.
It's also the tune for a weird and a John like Snorrits and Tha John by Lady Nairn. I might sing that at some point. I don't think I've done it. It's a sad song, but it's a beautiful tune. But anyway, I am going to sing Scotswahy. I wondered if that's my mum's nice way of saying stop, go away, stop going on a tangent. I love the way you two go off in tangents. I wonder if it's meant to be a sarcastic comment. I love it. Okay, so Scotswahy, we Wallace bled. Scotswahy, we Wallace bled. Scots and Bruce has often led, welcome to your gory bed, or to victory. Now's the day and now's the hour, see the Ferranto battle hour, see a approach proud Edward's power, chains and slavery. What will be a traitor knave? What will fill a coward's grave? What's the base as be a slave? Let him turn and flee. What for Scotland's king and law? Freedom's sword will strongly draw. Freeman stand or freeman fall. Let him follow me. By apparitions, woes and pains, by your sons in servile chains, we will draw our dearest fanes, but they shall be free. Lay the proud usurper's law, tyrants fall in every flaw, liberties in every blow, let us do or die. Scotswahy, we Wallace bled, Scotswahy Bruce has often led, welcome to your gory bed. Victory. I feel like I want to go go and shout freedom and run down the garden.
You can do that, but
finish
a gig first.
Yeah, a lot of people kind of think... I'm not keen on it like that.
You need to hear it at the Peter Hyde Burns.
Oh, yeah, I can imagine it's like...
They're arguing it loudly, but it's just, it's quite moving, actually.
Yeah. Well, I found out today that... I'm just telling you this because it's interesting. I'm not going to sing a song in it, but today is National Ferret Day. And as it happens, I actually know a song about a ferret, but I've sung it before and I thought, no, I'm not going to do it again. I looked at another song called My Grandfather's Ferret, which was a parody to My Grandfather's Clock. I think it was My Grandfather's Ferret, it was of little merit.
Is that Monty Python thing?
No, that was I've Got a Ferret Stuck Up My Nose. That was the Monty Python song that I also thought about doing. There's actually quite a few that I was thinking about doing tonight. If you know me, you'll know that I'm a massive fan of Doris Day. And it's Doris Day's birthday. Well, it would have been Doris Day's birthday tomorrow, the 3rd of April. She was born Marianne Kappelhoff on the 3rd of April, 1922. But I'm not going to sing a Doris Day song. I'm going to do some... Well, I'll sing a little bit of a Doris Day song and then I'll do my proper one. You hate this song.
I just think the lyrics are a bit...
I love you, a bushel and a peck, a bushel and a peck, and a hug around the neck, a hug around the neck, and a bottle and a heap. A bottle and a heap, and I'm talking in my sleep about you. Paul hates it.
I just think it's a... The lyrics are not great. Like.
Okay, right, I'm going to wheel you around anyway. And okay. We'll do. And look at this. This is exciting, folks. Because it's getting lighter nights, I left my curtains open so you can hear, look, and see what we've got in the windows, though.
All right, Milne's looking in the window across the park. He's still out.
Hello, Abdi. Can I take this slightly...
Closer.
Yeah, but then I probably need to adjust the actual level of it because it's going to cut me off at the eyes. It needs to be... Oh, yeah, that's fine.
How's that?
Yeah. Oh, I want to show you something first. This is what the marvellous Anne Wyatt, Paul and Anne, does fused glass thingamaze. And look how pretty is this. Anne made this with poppies and it sits in my windowsill. Isn't that beautiful? So go and look it up on Facebook. Thingamaze. Thingamies. So, anyway, my song for tonight, it was, yesterday would have been Simon Cowell's birthday. He was born the 1st of April, 1948. Not Simon Cowell, Simon Cowell. And he actually died in 2015. And he was a member of one of my favourite bands. And Paul mentioned... actually earlier that we went to this place a couple of years ago and didn't realise it was Good Friday and it was Hoche. Of course it is Lindisfarne. I absolutely love Lindisfarne, and Simon Cowell played guitar, piano, harmonium, mandolin, banjo, accordion, all sorts of stuff. He actually was educated at Fettes in Edinburgh. He was from Newcastle but he was educated at Fettes. And yeah, so this is a Lindisfarne song I thought I'd sing. Simon Cowell actually left Lindisfarne in 1993 to go and run a microbrewery in Toronto. So there's your interesting fact for today. There's lots of Lindisfarne songs that I could have sung, but I decided to do this one, Meet Me on the Corner. Paul, are you going to join in with a chorus?
I
can't
have words. Oh, right, okay. Like, sorry.
Meet Me on the Corner.
That's it.
No. Okay.
Good morning, Zap.
Tugging at your
just thought of another song that I could have done for the ferret.
Something by Oasis.
Ferret cross the Mersey. No? Sorry. That's really bad.
It's like Oasis from Manchester because they're mad.
Mad ferret. Yeah.
Well, that's us pretty much.
Yeah.
The end of the show. I think we're a wee bit earlier than the last couple of weeks. We're getting on. We're finishing about half past nine, which wasn't intention. We initially thought an hour would be plenty. But it's not BBC One or anything like that. We'd have to finish it at nine on the dot. But sometimes it's been creeping on. But I think we've not quite so late at the night.
I have no idea what time it is.
I'll check my watch. Quarter past. That's a good thing.
There was one person got the beer right.
There was
Phil Brandy.
Aye, well he comes to the place at Comfy, that's why.
Oh no, he did. I mean, he didn't get in for the bit. So.
Well, it's 6 degrees right. North.
Hypocrisy,
and this is Fate Lawrence Kirk. Now, hypocrisy. I think they were right because, mighty me, speak about hoppy. It made me grab my chicks, draw together like that. But like tasting notes, apricot, apple, and Madeira cake. Well, possibly. I was tasting hops.
Yeah, it was a bit too hoppy for me. Yeah. But it's good for Easter.
What is that?
Well, Easter bunnies hop.
Oh, sure. You've been on a crash course for your dad.
I'm so sorry.
You're getting good at these.
I'm just a natural comedian, you know. No, terrible.
What's in the box?
Nobody got it right tonight. No. What's in the box?
Right. Fit is in the box.
It's really weird. Nobody's commented for 15 minutes. I've not seen any.
Well, they're transfixed by the singing, sure. Oh. Either lot of the vagon here.
No, I had to update it. Sorry.
Ah, okay. Right, sorry. If we're not ignoring you. There was just nothing come in. So this is Fits in the Box tonight.
Sorry, I'm just
that, folks, out. Is... It's a Danny Award medal for Celtic Connections. I should just wear it all the time. Kind of picked on like this. Yeah. And just wear it, you can, like that. So I've got my Danny Award on. It's a Danny Award was named after Danny Kyle, who was a... hugely respected and influential chap for Glasgow, folk singer, but he was more than just that. He organised things as well. He was a good pal of Billy Connolly, actually, mm-hmm. as it happens. And Shona said that he was one of the founders of the Tuner Festival.
I don't know, but he definitely had something to do with Tuner, I think.
But I think he used to run the open stage thing.
Yeah, that's why Connections. It's
open stage. So when I actually won that, I mean, I did again. I was invited. Do you fancy coming to play Celtic Connections? Oh, hi, I'd love to. We'll come along on this night. And unbeknownst to me, it was like the open mic night. And it was actually a competition. Well, I got through to the final, and there was a few folk in the final that year, but Abdi got a prize. It was named one winner. So yeah. Anybody was at the final. Got an award, so it's grabs a nice thing to get. But anyway, that's what it is. Celtic Connections, Danny Kyle's a Danny Award is for that is.
Yeah, open to Danny Kyle. Open.
Yeah, so there you go. But that's cracking on a bit new.
Yeah.
it's about 2003. I got that. So.
But if you win a Danny, you actually get to go and perform the year after, don't you?
I did. Suite at the Royal Concert Hall, and I also you'll mind this night, Shona, because I played there, and then I played. I played at King Tut's Wawa Hut with Rock Salt and Nails.
That was the first year that I was in the Young Trad, so that was 2003. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And I, as part of our Friday night before the stuff on the, or was it Saturday night? I can't remember.
It was a Friday because I'd Chester Caledonian Bun Supper the next day.
Well,
I had to get a flight.
we got teen out for our dinner on the Friday night, and then we got teen a gig, and it was a Rock Salt and Nails gig at King Tut's Wawa Hut, and mm-hmm. I was like doing the front like a proper little fangirl, like, ah. I was only 17 as well. I wasn't even allowed properly in there, but I snuck in. And I remember that I fell down the stairs and I was like, oh, hope Paul Anderson didn't see that. I remember what you had on as well. I can remember you had on like a sleeveless basketball top.
See, this is showing my stalkering, my stalkerish tendencies.
I thought I had a shirt on for that.
Well, maybe.
I can't remember. No, it doesn't really just matter.
No.
You're definitely there. So, on it, but Dick, Kent Shona for the folk club in Huntley, so when I saw her, I definitely Kent Shona's at the concert.
I thought that. Do the front.
I thought you were cool, kind of. I'm like, Glasgow.
Yeah, absolutely. Anyway.
So, thanks for looking in,
happy
folks.
Happy Easter, everybody.
Aye, have a nice weekend.
Hope you have a lovely weekend.
We might be blocked in.
I
know,
because
the forecast and snow. I went to it just after tea time at night, and I have to say it was really pretty cold.
Smells like it, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's got that kind of chill in the back of your nose.
Smells like snow.
But regardless of the weather, we'll be back next week for 56, and I might do a workshop through the week, who knows. I did need for the Tayside Young Fiddlers on Tuesday, was it?
Yeah, Tuesday.
So it's nice to do stuff like that, but... Aye, we'll certainly be here next week.
And if you have enjoyed tonight and you fancy bunging something in the tip jar, that would be appreciated. It's www.paypal.me/PaulAndersonShonaDon.
So, we're going to finish with a tune. We played this last year, actually, but it's the last tune that I've recorded for the William Christie collection, which is published in 1820. And it's called... It's nae aye for want of health that the lady's gone to Pananach. Now, Pananach Wells is up near Ballater. In fact, Pananach Wells was actually founded afore Ballater itself, actually. Yeah. But that's a different story. But it's a great tune, and a couple of days I'll be finished all these Christie tunes. I've got 12.
Are you happy about that?
Aye. It just feels like progress when you get through, and it's like, oh, I've done that. It's
have
good.
You enjoyed this collection, though?
I have. A lot of tunes I didn't ken. Mestly tunes I didn't ken, I have to say. And not just his aliens, but there's a lot of old tunes in this collection that I've never seen before, and would have been very current up in Buchan, which is very comfy, Cummiston, near Turriff. So this is not one of his tunes, though. In the book, it's just described as being old. So in 1820, this was considered an old tune. So
for the want of health, the lady's gone to ban it.
It's a good tune. So we'll see you next week.
Are you doing it once or twice?
Twice. Stay safe, wear your masks.
Happy Easter.
Cheerio.